Give us 30 seconds and I'll show you an amazing battery tip as we work our way into the settings you need to turn on in iOS 18. Let's open up Settings and then Battery. And then we're going to turn on Battery Percentage at the top, which just turns on the battery percentage. But while we're here, scroll down to this battery usage section and then tap on last 10 days. Then scroll down a little more and tap on show activity. And what we want to look for here is that the on-screen number on the left side matches or approximately matches the number on the right side. That's the sign of a healthy app. It's only using your battery while you're using it and maybe a little bit more after you close it, which is normal. So on my phone, first off, mail here. 20 minutes on screen, 7.5 hours in the background. What went wrong here? Well, a message got stuck in my outbox because I mistyped an email address. That'll happen. I cleared up my outbox. That problem went away. Let's find another problem app. Godox Lite here, 30 minutes on screen, 11 hours and 15 minutes in the background. Godox Lite is the app we use to control some of the lights in the studio here, but there is no reason for it to drain my battery and keep running in the background when I'm not using it. So what can we do about it? Let's tap back to Settings. And then we're going to go to General, tap on that, and we're going to go to Background App Refresh, tap on that. If you've seen our other videos before, we talk about Background App Refresh quite a bit, but I think that this Godox app may have slipped through the cracks the last time I optimized my phone. So let's scroll down here. I'm going to find the Godox app. Godox. Godox Lite switches on. Turn it off. If you want more no-nonsense tips like the one you just heard, hit the subscribe button because this is the place to be. And I promise, for the rest of the video, we're going to talk about settings to turn on because I know that's why you're here. Tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, back again to Settings, and we're going to go to Messages, which used to be in this main menu, but now we need to go all the way to the bottom, then tap on Apps, and rather than scrolling through this entire list, I'm just going to swipe up, and then tap in the search field, type in mess, and then open up messages. iOS 18 brings some amazing new features to the messages app. Let's start with probably the most important one, which is RCS. Scroll down to RCS messaging, tap on that, and make sure that this switch is turned on. This is a huge deal, and we do have the EU to thank for this. They love to sue big companies like Apple, but finally, we can share full quality photos with Android users. We can see the little bubbles when they're typing to us. It's kind of like iMessage Lite, not as slick as the integration between Apple devices, but a huge step forward from what we've been using up until now. Let's tap back to messages, and while we're here, scroll up to text message forwarding. Tap on that. If you've signed into iMessage on another Apple device, it will show up here. So if you want to use the Messages app to send text messages from your Mac or iPad, turn these switches on. Let's tap back, scroll down to the Mentions section, and let's turn on the switch next to Notify Me. This is a great feature for when you silence your family group chat about Thanksgiving. You don't want your phone to be blowing up with messages, but you do want to know if somebody asks you to bring the pie. Next, scroll down to audio messages and tap on the expire menu here. If a picture is worth 1,000 words, then an audio message must be worth at least enough to save for more than 2 minutes. I'm not sure why 2 minutes is the default. Probably a privacy thing. Next, we're going to go back to the main page of settings. So I'll tap messages here in the upper left, then back to apps, then cancel, and then back to the main page of settings. Then we're going to scroll up to accessibility, tap on that, and then we're going to scroll down to Siri and tap on that. First up, Siri pause time. Sometimes I don't get all of my words out smoothly. This makes Siri wait a little bit longer if I take a break in the middle of a sentence. So I'm just going to come here and choose longest. That works for me. Next, we'll scroll down to Always Listen for Siri. This lets Siri listen for you to say her name, even when your phone is face down. Not sure if that's something you want to have on, but I do, so I'll turn on the switch. Next, require Siri for interruptions. Let's say you told her to do something and then changed your mind. Now you can just say Siri in a new command, and she'll disregard the first one. I'll turn this switch on. Next is listen for atypical speech, which I've already turned on. This is a cool concept. When you use Siri, does she activate too often or not enough? For me, the answer is not enough. I turned this on yesterday to see if Siri would accidentally activate all the time. No problems so far. If you think Siri could be a better listener, turn the switch on. Before we move on, we talk about a lot of settings in these videos. If you want a free PDF guide you can print out and follow along at your own pace, click the join button below the video. Next, scroll down to call hangup. Let's open this menu. This is a no-brainer. Let's say you're fed up with a telemarketer, you want to hang up on them. Now you don't even have to lift a finger. Hey Siri, hang up. You could say that now. Next, let's go back to Siri and then back again. We're going to scroll all the way to the top of this menu as I move the phone and then tap on motion to open that menu. Let's talk about these three autoplay switches. I want animated images and message effects to play automatically, but not video previews. Because if you have friends with boundary issues, autoplay can be dangerous. Next, back to the main page of settings, scroll down and tap on touch. Then we're going to scroll down and talk about prevent lock to end call. This prevents you from accidentally hanging up on somebody if you press the power button during a phone call. And as an aside, I love this tap or swipe to wake feature. Something oddly satisfying about smashing my phone after I wake up in the morning. Next, we'll tap back and let's scroll all the way down here to the speech section of accessibility settings and tap on vocal shortcuts for a game-changing new way to use your iPhone. First, let's turn on the switch next to vocal shortcuts. Then we're gonna add an action, tap continue. We can have anything we say trigger the action button or the app switcher or the camera. I'm not gonna read them all, but I am gonna choose flashlight. Now we'll choose a custom phrase, you light up my life. Tap go. Now I can say, you light up my life. Boom, flashlight on. Let us know what vocal shortcuts you set up in the comments section below. Always looking for suggestions. Let's tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, back again to settings. We're gonna go down to the apps section again and open that up. Then swipe to the top to search for Safari. And I'll tap to open the Safari menu. This is one of the first places you can really see Apple intelligence in action. Scroll down and turn on the switch here next to highlights. And while we're here, let's make sure that prevent cross-site tracking is turned on, as well as require Face ID to unlock private browsing, just in case there's something in there you don't want other people to see. And tap the switch next to fraudulent website warning, a super important new switch that could save you a lot of money. Let's tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, then tap cancel to get out of this menu and back again to settings. Now we're gonna scroll up to action button. Tap on that. This section of settings isn't new, but there are some new things in here in iOS 18. I'll swipe over here to controls. This is the new part. I'll tap choose a control. And all of these things are now available for the action button. I'll keep mine on ChatGPT because that's my favorite use of the action button. Let us know what your favorite use of that button is in the comments section below. I'll tap back to settings in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and then tap on camera. Then I'm gonna scroll down and let's take a look at this portraits in photo mode setting. This is an amazing feature. Now when you take a photo, your iPhone captures depth information that lets you turn that photo into a portrait mode photo after the fact, which is awesome. So I'm just gonna tap this switch to turn it on. There are a whole slew of amazing features in this section of settings. Why aren't we making the camera video right now? Well, I'm waiting until I get the iPhone 16 Pro because it stinks to make a video and then have the whole thing be out of date the next day. Next setting. I'll tap back to settings in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and then scroll to the top. Then I'll tap on my name at the top, tap sign in and security, then come on down here to automatic verification. Tap on that. This feature is a no-brainer to have on because it bypasses Captchas on the web and inside apps. Let's tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and go back one more time to the Apple account menu. Then we're gonna tap on iCloud Then we're going to scroll down a little bit and tap on Private Relay here to open that up. People use VPNs for reasons that can be divided into two categories, legal and illegal. iCloud Private Relay is a great VPN for those of us who aren't using VPNs to do illegal things. But if you don't want websites to break, tap on IP address location and choose Maintain General Location. This lets websites know approximately where you are, but not exactly where you are. So if you visit a local news website, for instance, they'll show you relevant articles, but they won't know exactly who you are. Let's tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and back once more to iCloud, and make sure you're backing up your phone. It's just super important. Tap on iCloud Backup, make sure backup this iPhone is on, and make sure backup over cellular is turned off, even if you have an unlimited data plan. Because your unlimited data plan has a high-speed data cap, this will easily go over that cap and cause your entire plan to slow down. Next, new iOS 18 setting, I'll tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, back again, and back one more time. I'm gonna scroll down, let's open up General, and we'll scroll down to the brand new Autofill and Passwords section of settings. All your passwords used to live in the Settings app, but in iOS 18, they've moved to Apple's brand new Passwords app. These settings give your iPhone permission to go into that password app or other password apps, get your password, and then autofill them on websites or in other apps. If you use iCloud to manage your passwords like I do, make sure the switch next to passwords is turned on. And to avoid headaches, make sure that the other password managers on your phone, in my case, Chrome, Google, and Opera, make sure these are all turned off. While we're here, make sure the delete after use switch is turned on next to verification code. This is designed to keep your messages app and your email free of those verification codes that we're all used to, but it only deletes them if you use the built-in autofill feature on your phone. If you type it in manually, they will still be there. Let's tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, tap on AirDrop at the top here, and I'll turn on the switch next to bringing devices together. Having this switch on does not mean that a thief can bump into your iPhone and steal your contact information or your photos. Next, tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and then tap AirPlay and Continuity. And if you have a Mac, this is where a lot of cool features live, especially handoff and continuity camera, both super cool things to have on. Next, tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, go back to Settings, then tap on Cellular, tap on Cellular Data Options, and turn on the switch next to Limit IP Address Tracking. This is good stuff for your privacy. Next up, data roaming. I'm gonna turn it on because I have Verizon and I live in the US. But if I was traveling overseas or had a carrier where roaming was still a thing, I definitely would turn this off. When in doubt, check with your carrier, but for most people in the US anyway, it's a good idea to have the switch turned on to get the best service. Next setting to turn on, I'll tap back. Come on down here to Wi-Fi Assist. Turn that switch on. This smooths out the transition between good Wi-Fi and no Wi-Fi by letting cellular data fill in the gap when you leave home, for instance. Next, tap back to settings and scroll up to Wi-Fi. Then tap the I on the right-hand side of your home Wi-Fi network. Then tap private Wi-Fi address. Let's imagine you're going to a Halloween party. When this switch is off, it's like you're not wearing a costume. Everybody can see what you're doing. But if you throw open the punch bowl and they kick you out, they're not gonna let you back in. Rotating is like changing costumes every time you leave and come back, so nobody ever knows who you are when you walk in the door. Continuing this crazy metaphor, your home Wi-Fi router is like the host of the party. Home Wi-Fi routers are not good at keeping track of too many different devices. When your phone is on rotating, it looks like a new phone is connecting to your home Wi-Fi every time you leave and come back, which can slow down your network and even break it. So Fixed is the happy medium that maintains your privacy and keeps your network at home running smoothly. Next up, a photo setting. So I'll tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and back again. Back once more. Photos is no longer in this list, so I'll tap apps, and then swipe, tap in the search, and type pho. Then I'll open photos. Then make sure the switch here next to Use Face ID is turned on. This requires Face ID to view the hidden album and recently deleted albums, which can protect your privacy. Next, I'll tap back to apps, tap cancel, back to settings. Then I'm going to scroll up to Control Center and tap on that. Make sure the switch next to Access Within Apps is turned on so that you can access Control Center from wherever you are. And all the settings that used to be in this part of the Settings app have now moved to Within Control Center, which is a new iOS 18 feature. And that is not this video. That is the next video we're going to put out. So make sure you hit the subscribe button and the notifications bell if you want to get one eensy teensy alert when that video comes out. Thank you very much for watching this video. Watch our settings to turn off video if you haven't already, and we will see you soon.